हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा 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 हरे हरे। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू भगवान श्री कृष्णा राधा माधव एंड ऑल ग्लोरीज टू श्रीला प्रभुपाद, जगत गुरु श्रीला प्रभुपाद, बाई हुज मर्सी वी आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिवाइन वर्ड्स ऑफ भगवान श्री कृष्णा। हरे कृष्णा गाइज, सो इन दिस वीडियो विल रीड वर्स नंबर्स 13 एंड 14 ऑफ चैप्टर 2। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ वर्स नंबर 13। वर्स नंबर 13 गोज लाइक दिस। देहि नोऽस्मिन् यथा देहे कौमारं यौवनं जरा तथा देहांतर प्राप्ते धीरस्तत्र नमोयति। देहिन ऑफ द एम्बॉडीड अश्मिन इन दिस यथा एज देहे इन द बॉडी कौमारम बॉयहुड यौवनम युथ जरा ओल्ड एज तथा सिमिलरली देहांतर ऑफ ट्रांसफरेंस ऑफ द बॉडी प्राप्ति ही अचीवमेंट धीर द सोबर तत्र देर अपॉन न नेवर मोयति इज डिलूडेड। So Bhagwan continues to say, as the embodied soul continuously passes in this body from boyhood to youth to old age, the soul similarly passes into another body at death. A sober person is not bewildered by such a change. Right? Bhagwan says that as the embodied soul continuously passes in this body from boyhood to youth to old age, the soul similarly passes into another body at death. Right? A sober person is not bewildered by such a change. So, purport given by His grace, since every living entity is an individual soul, each is changing his body every moment, manifesting sometimes as a child, sometimes as a youth, and sometimes as an old man. Right? Yet the same spirit soul is there and does not undergo any change. This individual soul finally changes the body at death and transmigrates to another body, and since it is sure to have another body in the next birth, either material or spiritual, there was no cause for lamentation by Arjuna on account of death, neither for Bhishma nor for Drona, for whom he was so much concerned. Rather, he should rejoice for their changing bodies from old to new ones, thereby rejuvenating their energy. Such changes of body account for varieties of enjoyment or suffering according to one's work in life. So Bhishma and Drona, being noble souls, were surely going to have spiritual bodies in the next life, or at least life in heavenly bodies for superior enjoyment of material existence. So in either case, there was no cause of lamentation. Any man who has perfect knowledge of the constitution of the individual soul, the super soul and nature, both material and spiritual, is called a dhira or a most sober man. Such a man is never deluded by the change of bodies. The Mayavadi theory of oneness of the spirit soul cannot be entertained on the ground that the spirit soul cannot be cut into pieces as a fragmental portion. Such cutting into different individual souls would make the supreme cleavable or changeable, right? Such cutting into different individual souls would make the supreme cleavable or changeable against the principle of the supreme souls being unchangeable, right? As confirmed in the Gita, the fragmental portions of the supreme exist eternally, right? Sanatana, and are called Shara, that is, they have a tendency to fall down into material nature. These fragmental portions are eternally so, and even after liberation, the individual soul remains the same fragmental. But once liberated, he lives an eternal life in bliss and knowledge with the personality of Godhead. Right? The theory of reflection can be applied to the super soul, who is present in each and every individual body and is known as the Paramatma. He is different from the ही इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द इंडिविजुअल लिविंग एंटिटी, राइट? परमात्मा इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द इंडिविजुअल लिविंग एंटिटी. लाइक व्हेन द स्काई इज रिफ्लेक्टेड इन वाटर, व्हेन द स्काई इज रिफ्लेक्टेड इन वाटर, द रिफ्लेक्शंस रिप्रेजेंट बोथ द सन एंड द मून एंड द स्टार्स ऑल्सो. द स्टार्स कैन बी कंपेयर्ड टू द लिविंग एंटिटीज एंड द सन और द मून टू द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड, राइट? द स्टार्स विच आर रिफ्लेक्टिंग इन द पॉन्ड, in the water, they can be compared to the living entities, and the sun and the moon which are reflecting on the water can be compared to the supreme lord. The individual fragmental spirit soul is represented by Arjuna, and the supreme soul is the personality of Godhead Shri Krishna, right? They are not on the same level, as it will be apparent in the beginning of the coming fourth chapter. If Arjuna is on the same level with Krishna and Krishna is not superior to Arjuna, then their relationship of instructor and instructed becomes meaningless, right? If both of them are deluded by the illusory energy Maya, then there is no need of one being the instructor and the other the instructed. Such instruction would be useless, because in the clutches of Maya, no one can be an authoritative instructor, right? Under the circumstances, it is admitted that Lord Krishna is the Supreme Lord, superior in position to the living entity Arjuna, who is a forgetful soul deluded by Maya, right, on the battlefield. So guys, now we'll move to verse number 14. Verse number 14 goes like this. Matra sparshastu kaunteya sitoshna sukha dukhadaha agamapayino nitya stamstitik shashva bharata, right? Matra sparshaha, sensory perception, tu only kaunteya, O son of Kunti, Sita, winter, Ushna, summer, Sukha, happiness, Dukha, and pain, Daha, giving, Agama, appearing, Apayinaha, disappearing, Anityaha, non-permanent, Tan, all of them, Titikshashva, just try to tolerate, Bharata, O descendant of the Bharata dynasty. So Bhagavan says to Arjuna, O son of Kunti, the non-permanent appearance of happiness and distress and their disappearance in due course are like the appearance and disappearance of winter and summer seasons. They arise from sense perception, O son of Bharata, and one must learn to tolerate them without being disturbed. O son of Kunti, the non-permanent appearance of happiness and distress and their disappearance in due course are like the appearance and disappearance of winter and summer seasons. They arise from sense perceptions, O son of Bharata, and one must learn to tolerate them without being disturbed. Very important verse. So purport given by His Grace. In the proper discharge of duty, one has to learn to tolerate non-permanent appearances and disappearances of happiness and distress. According to Vedic injunction, one has to take his bath early in the morning, even during the month of Magha, January, February, during the winter season. It is very cold at that time, but in spite of that, a man who abides by the religious principles does not hesitate to take his bath. Similarly, a woman does not hesitate to cook in the kitchen even in the months of May and June, right? The hottest part of the summer season. One has to execute his duty in spite of climatic inconveniences, right? Similarly, to fight is the religious principle of the Kshatriyas. And although one has to fight with some friend or relative, one should not deviate from his prescribed duty. One has to follow the prescribed rules and regulations of religious principles in order to rise up to the platform of knowledge. One has to follow the prescribed rules and regulations of religious principles in order to rise up to the platform of knowledge, because by knowledge and devotion only can one liberate himself from the clutches of Maya. The two different names of address given to Arjuna are also significant. To address him as Kaunteya signifies his great blood relations from his mother's side, right? भगवान इज एड्रेसिंग अर्जुन एज कौंतेया बिकॉज ही वॉन्ट्स टू स्ट्रेस दैट रिलेशनशिप, दैट ब्लड रिलेशनशिप दैट भगवान हैज, भगवान इन दिस इन द मॉर्टल बॉडी हैज विद अर्जुन. एंड टू एड्रेस हिम एज भारत सिग्निफाइज हिज ग्रेटनेस फ्रॉम हिज फादर्स साइड, राइट. फ्रॉम बोथ साइड्स ही इज सपोज टू हैव अ ग्रेट हेरिटेज. A great heritage brings responsibility in the matter of proper discharge of duties. Therefore, he cannot avoid fighting. Right? So, great was this one, guys. So, guys, in the next video, we'll continue from verse number 15. Before ending this video, let's read this verse again, because this is a very interesting verse. Very interesting verse being told by Bhagavan Shri Krishna. And also, let's pay our respects to Srila Prabhupada, because of whom we are able to understand the divine words of Bhagavan Shri Krishna, right? So let's read this verse again for our benefit, extra benefit. Matra sparshastu kaunteya sitoshna sukha dukadaha agama paino nitya stam titikshashva bharata. O son of Kunti, right? When Bhagavan is addressing to Arjuna, he is not just only addressing to Arjuna, he is addressing to all of us who are currently in the Kali Yuga. So, let's read it from this perspective that Bhagavan is addressing to us who are currently reading this, right? O son of Kunti, O son of Kunti, O the people of Kali Yugas, the non-permanent appearance of happiness and distress and their disappearance in due course are like the appearance and disappearance of winter and summer seasons. They arise from sense perception, O sign of Bharata, right? O people of Kali Yuga, and one must learn to tolerate them without being disturbed. Okay. So guys, in the next video, we'll continue from verse number 15. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.